गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू इंग्लिश क्लास। सो प्रीवियस क्लास आई टॉट एडजेक्टिव्स, राइट? डू यू रिमेंबर दैट व्हाट इज एडजेक्टिव? एन एडजेक्टिव इज ए डिस्क्राइबिंग वर्ड, इट डिस्क्राइब्स ए नाउन और प्रोनाउन। सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन एडवर्ब्स। आई थिंक इन द प्रीवियस क्लास आई गेव इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द एडवर्ब्स। व्हाट इज एडवर्ब? एन एडवर्ब इज ए वर्ड व्हिच डिस्क्राइब्स ए वर्ब। Adjective describes noun or pronoun, but adverb describes a verb. Verb means action word, right? So here, if some action has done, if some action has done, how that action has done, when that action has done, and where that action has done. So adverb describes these things. Okay, adverb describes tells something about the verb. Okay. So sit properly, everyone sit properly, maintain distance. Okay, look at here. So an adverb describes a verb. An adverb describes a verb. Okay, adverb describes a verb. Action. Page number 16 in your grammar book. Okay, so for example, one of the boys walking. So how he was walking? He walked slowly. For example, he walked slowly. Look at here. How he is walking now? I'm asking the question. Walked is the action word, a verb. Okay, some action is going on here. So how that action is going on? How the boy is walking? He was walking slowly. So here, slowly is adverb. It tells about the verb. It tells about the action. How the action has done. Did you understand? Next one. The soldiers fought courageously. The soldiers fought courageously. Okay, soldiers are fighting. How they are fighting? They are fighting courageously, right? How they are fighting? They are fighting courageously. Okay, fighting is a verb. Courageously is adverb. Okay, it talks something about the action. Okay, next, I told you when that action happened and where that action happened. So when that action happened, for example, when will you start? If I ask you when will you start, we will start tomorrow. Look at here. So start is the verb. Okay. So now I ask you, when will you start? Then what is your answer? We will start tomorrow. Here, tomorrow is talking about when that action happened. So here, this is adverb. Okay. Next, for example, if I ask you where that action happened, okay. So she is sitting upstairs. Where she is sitting? She is sitting in the upstairs. So where sitting is the verb. Where she is sitting? She is sitting in the upstairs. So here upstairs is talking about where that action has happened. Okay, do you understand? So here upstairs is the adverb. Okay, right. Okay, Shall I raise? Okay.
Already in the previous class I taught this. Just to remember you. Okay. Now I'm going to explain preposition. What is preposition? An example of preposition. Okay. Preposition. Preposition.
Okay. So what is preposition? A preposition is a word which is placed before a noun to show its relation to some other object in a sentence. Okay. A preposition is a noun which shows or which placed before a noun. Preposition placed before a noun. Why it placed? To show the relation between the other object. Okay. To show the relation between two sentences. Okay.
Preposition is a word. First, I'll write the definition, then I'll explain. Don't talk. A preposition is a word which placed, before a noun to show relation to some other object in a sentence.
Now let's look at here. Preposition is a word which placed before a noun to show relation to some other object in a sentence. Okay. If I now I like one of the examples so that you can easily understand. She plucked a rose flower from the garden. She plucked a rose flower
from the garden.
Look at here. She plucked a rose flower from the garden. So what is the preposition here? Which the word which shows the relation between the two objects. Okay. For example, she plucked a rose flower. Okay. She plucked a rose flower from the garden. What is the relation between rose flower and the garden? She plucked the flower from the garden. Okay. So here, from is showing the relation between two objects. What is the relation between the flower and the garden? The flower which taken from the garden. Okay. Did you understand? Look at here. Next one. Next. The dog sits near the door. So what is the relation between the dog and the door? It is sitting near the door. So here, near is showing the relation between the dog and the door. Okay. So here, near is called preposition. Okay. Hello. Listen here. Next. The book is on the table. Okay. So here, look at here. What is the relation between the book and the table? What is the relation here? The book is on the table. Where is that book? The book is on the table. So here, on is the preposition which is talking about the relation between the book and the table. Okay. For example, the cat is under the table. So what is the relation between the cat and the table? Under. Okay, under is showing the relation between the cat and the table. The cat is sitting under the table. Okay, did you understand? The fish is in the water. What is the relation between the water and fish? The fish is in the water. In is showing the relation between the fish and water. Okay, so these are called prepositions. Some more examples are right here. Okay, important prepositions. Some more important prepositions. Write first. Make it fast. Have you written, ma? I'm getting a light. Some examples here. Write fast. Don't take much time. Okay, look at here, above, along, right? Prepositions. Above, along, behind, beyond, behind, beyond, up to, across, among, below, across, among, below, by, in, on, after, it, beside, after, it, beside, except, into, outside, under, against, before, against, before, between, for, from, near, over, up, with, over, up, with. So these are some more examples of preposition, right? Some words are there to add more prepositions also there. Out of, in front of, in the middle of, we can write like that. Are you ready? Hello? Write it. Write first. After completion of this, open your worksheet, ma. So now I'm going to explain worksheet. Remaining part I'll explain tomorrow. Okay. Conjunction and interjection I'll explain in tomorrow's class. Now open your worksheet. Write fast. Make it fast, ma'am. Okay, open day one here.
Day one, no blanks here.
Okay, look at here. Day one, write the given new words. First, you should write the new words here. Booty, hubbub, fearsome. Owl, steel, threshing, hollering, salon, gaily. So now what you have to do after learning these new words, first of all you should learn the new words. Then after learning you should write the missing letters. Down they have given missing letters. So you should fill the letters so that you will get the correct word. Okay. That is day one. Next, day two. Day two, once open day two, things that can be counted are called countable nouns. You know nouns, there are today here nouns, countable and uncountable nouns. Here given countable nouns, things that can be counted. For example, if you take a book, can you count the books? If I have one book, if I have one more book, I can count two books, three books, four books, right? Duster, we can count the duster also, one duster, two duster, three duster. Piece of stuff, 1, 2, 3, we can count, right? So the things which can be counted are called countable nouns. Okay, so look at here examples of countable nouns. For example, books, dogs, pens, apples, etc. we can count. Okay, and singular plural forms here, boys, boy singular, boys plural, right? Bench, benches, child, children, man, men, girl, girls, book, books, box, boxes, car, cars. So next one, match the following. We should match down here after reading those singulars and plural forms. Then we have to match here. Pen, we should match with pens, right? Book, we should match with books. Like that, child, children, boy, boys. Like that, we have to match here. That is day two, ma. And day three. Yes, day three English words, look at here. Now, which cannot be counted are called uncountable nouns. Just now I told you countable nouns. Countable nouns is which can be able to count, which can count. Okay, here the nouns which cannot be counted, we can't count them. Such nouns are called uncountable nouns. For example, if you take water, can you count the water like one drop water, two drop water, three drop water? Can you count that? No, we can't count. Can you count the rice?
No.
1, 2, 3, like that. Can you count? For example, head. You know, your head is head.
No.
Can you count that?
No.
Can you count eye?
No.
Can you count sand? No. Such nouns are called uncountable nouns. Why? Because we can't count them, right?
Yeah.
Yes, very good. So here, examples of uncountable nouns given. Honey, honey also we can't count. Cheese, floor, news, sunlight, water, sugar, oil. These are the examples of uncountable nouns. So now, write the examples of uncountable nouns. Here are some examples given and some more examples you have to write down. Okay, just I explained what are the uncountable nouns. That's some five examples you should write your own. Okay, so that is day three. And day four,
look at here.
Therefore, read and understand the practice the given collective nouns. Here, collective nouns refers to a group which has at least more than 2-3 numbers. So, collective nouns means a group of nouns. A group of nouns are called collective nouns. Just I said that, you know, if we have a one book, okay, we can count 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, we have so many books. Can you see what we call them? If we have one book, we can say one book. Two, then we can say two. Three. So if I have so many books, then how can we say books? A library of books. A group of books are called a library of books. Okay. Example, if you have so many flowers together, then what will you call that? A bouquet of flowers, right? A group of flowers are called a bouquet of flowers. Okay. For example, you know keys. Keys, you know lock, you have keys. So those keys, if you have so many keys with you, then what we call a bunch of keys, right? A bunch of keys. So, a group of birds are called a flock of birds. Do you understand? For example, you are the students. You know, you are sitting in the class. So many students are sitting in the class. What we call the group of students? A class of students. We call them a class of students. So, if you are so many people and so many students are there together, so we can call a class of students. Okay. Have you seen the stars in the sky? So many stars are there. Can you count those stars? No. So what we call those group of stars? A cluster of stars. You know fish? Fish live in the water. So a group of fish, what we call them? A shoal of fish. A shoal of fish. Okay? So these are the names of the group. Okay? If we collected the nouns, a group of nouns are called collective nouns. Some examples given here. Look at here. Read this. We saw a herd of elephants in our trip to the national park. So when he went to, he saw a group of elephants. What we call a group of elephants? A herd of elephants. Okay. Next, an army of soldiers. Have you seen the soldiers? Yes. We can see soldiers, so many soldiers together. So what we call them? An army of soldiers. Okay. For example, people, you know, if you have seen that in the ration shop, there are so many people gathered together. What we call them? A crowd of people. Okay. Next, you know, just now I told you, if the students are sitting together, what we call them? A class of students. Next, players. Have you seen the cricket players or some other games players? What we call them? A team of players. My team, you are saying. Why we call that team? Why? Because there are a group of people are there. That's why we can say a team of players. Next, a family of people. A group of dancers. A band of musicians, a choir of singers. These are the collective nouns. So, up to 4th worksheet you have to complete today, okay? Tomorrow I will explain next worksheet. Here I am going to conclude the class. Hope you understand today's class. Thank you.